Everybody, so this is a lecture number 8 from modern control theory, and mainly we will be discussing about the solution of the state space forms, that is xt, solution of states is xt. So, and mainly restricted to the homogeneous differential equations, whether it is scalar one or vector differential equation. So, what is homogeneous differential equation? It can be defined as a function fxy is said to be homogeneous of degree n if the equation satisfies this condition fzx, zy equal to z ki power n fxy. Example 1, if you are considering fxy equal to x square plus y square, then fzx by zy equal to zx square plus zy square equal to, taking z square as common, so it is z square fxy simply. So this is satisfying above condition of the expression, this one, therefore it is called as homogeneous equation of second order or second degree. If you are considering another example, fxy equal to this one of order or degree 1, then multiply or replace x by zx and y by zy, then z can be taken as common and it is z fxy, therefore it is called as homogeneous equation. Now, considering homogeneous state equations, so here in one case it is, we are considering as a scalar differential equation, that is the unforced systems. Unforced system does mean there is no input signal in consideration. So x dot t equal to axt is the best example for this one. So here ut is absent, does mean there is no input signal in consideration, therefore it is called as unforced system or scalar differential equation. A small a is considered as a small scalar quantity. Now, if you are considering the solution xt or state xt as this expression, a power series b0 plus b1t plus b2t, b2t square plus b3tq plus so on, bk, tk, then take differentiation of this xt expression with respect to time, you would be getting b1, b0 would be 0, therefore next it is b1 plus 2b2t, because b2 t square is there, so 2b2t plus 3b3 t square, and similarly for bk tk it is k bk t ki power k minus 1. So in this way you have calculated dxt over dt of the assumed state in terms of power series. It is sometimes called as power series method in control systems language. So the arrangement of axt is equal to a, if we consider for the first equation axt, so xt, if you are putting this value from here to this one, then it would be axt equal to a b0 plus b1t plus b2t square plus b3tq plus so on plus bk tk. Now this is another, and left side we have considered LHS is calculated from here. Now these two expressions, this one and this, both should be equal, and to comparing these one, b1 equal to ab0, see this is b1, it should be equal to ab0, and similarly 2b2 equal to ab1, 2b2 equal to ab1, b1 is already calculated, that is ab0, therefore it would be 1, b2 would be equal to 1 over 2 ab1 or 1 by 2 a into b1 equal to ab0. Therefore, it is equal to 1 over 2 a square b 0. Now, consider third term, that is 3b3 t squares coefficient is 3b3, and here it is a b2. So 3b3 equal to a b2, so b3 would be equal to 1 over 3 a b2. Now put the value of b2, so a over 3 into putting the value of b2, b2 from here, right? So a over 3 into 1 over a square b0, so it would be equal to 1 over 6 a3 a cube b0. Similarly for bk, now what would happen? Actually you have calculated b1, b2, b3, bk. Why? For what reason? Because we have assumed that this is the solution for this differential equation. Therefore, we have to calculate the values of these constants. Therefore, for solving or taking the solution of the state equation, xt would be equal to put the values of b1, b2, b3, bk. On further solution, you would be getting. Now, what b0 stands for? B0 stands for, if you are considering a state value at t equal to 0, then it is x0. Other terms would be equal to 0. Therefore, x0 equal to v0. So here, see, x0 equal to b0 at t equal to 0. That is the initial condition. So put b0 equal to x0, and remaining expression would be 1 plus at plus 1 over 2 a square t square plus 1 over factorial 3 or 6, the same 1 over factorial 3 a cube t cube plus so on plus 1 over factorial k a key power k t key power k. This expression is known as a key power at. Therefore, the solution of this state equation, that is xt equal to e key power at x0. If you are considering this x dot t equal to small a t, instead of small a, you are taking capital A, that is vector homogeneous differential equation. So in this case, we are considering vector differential equation, x dot t equal to capital A x t. So x t would be equal to, on similar steps, x t equal to x0, one key, one, instead of one you are putting here as identity matrix A, I plus A t plus 1 over 2 a square t square plus 1 over factorial 3 a cube t cube plus so on plus 1 over factorial k a key power k t k. This is e, can this can be replaced by e key power a t. Therefore, the solution would be equal to xt equal to e key power a t x0. This e key power a t can further be defined by this expression, because this is equal to this one. This is having a specific name in control system, that is state transition matrix. So now the same approach, the same evolution can be, or solution of the state can be determined by following the Laplace method or Laplace approach. What is the limitation of previous method? That is called as power series method. Power series method would be very much cumbersome in case of large systems. So it is better to go to Laplace approach. What would happen if we are considering a scalar differential equation and vector matrix differential equation? You would be simply determining the Laplace transform of this state equation as xs minus x0 equal to axs, and taking xs as common, s minus a equal to x0, xs equal to x0 over s minus a. Now take Laplace inverse of this one, this expression, then you will be getting xt equal to 1 over s, Laplace inverse of 1 over s minus a, that is e to the power a t into x0. So this is the solution for this differential equation instead of going to power series method as we have discussed previous first case. In previous examples, second case, using the power series method, we have considered the vector matrix differential equation, that is x dot t equal to capital A x x t. So again take Laplace transform of this one. So what would happen here, since it is a matrix, this is a matrix. So S operator should be multiplied by I minus capital A. Instead of small a, it should be capital A. So take the Laplace inverse of this one, and you will be again having the same formula. Here small a is replaced by capital A. So xt equal to e to the power at x0 is the solution for state equation x dot equal to ax. Now considering one example, if you are given a system as x dot t equal to system matrix A into xt, and initial condition for this system are given by x0 equal to 1 over minus 1, then first state equation can be written as x dot t equal to minus x1 t plus 0 x2 t. So x dot x1 dot t equal to minus x1 t, which is equal to, if we consider the scalar differential equation, then small a x1 t, so small a equal to minus 1, so x1 equal to, solution would be x1 t equal to e to the power a t x1 0. Here x1 0, what is x1 0? This one, this is x1 0, this is x2 0. So x1 0 equal to 1, so e raised to minus 1, small a value is minus 1, so e raised to minus 1 t into the value of x10, that is 1, so into 1 equal to e to the power minus t. Similarly for second state equation, x dot t equal to minus 2x2 t x equal to ax2 t, so the value of a would be equal to minus 2. So e to the power minus 2 in this one, e to the power minus 2 t would be e to the power a t, and a equal to x2 equal to minus 1, so it is multiplied by this minus 1, so solution will be 2 e to the power minus 2 t. So the solution is x1 t equal to e to the power minus t, and x2 t equal to e to the power x2 t equal to 2 into e to the power minus 2 t. Now considering the state transition matrix, that is we have already defined by power series method or Laplace transform method, e to the power at equal to the expression, that is 1 plus at a square t square over factorial 2 plus a cube t cube over factorial 3 plus so on, and this is called e to the power at, and the solution is given by this one, xt equal to e to the power at into x0. This is also called as phi t, that is state transition matrix phi t, so it is multiplied by x0. So why phi t, which is already defined as this e to the power a t is equal to Laplace inverse of s I minus e inverse, Laplace inverse of 1 over s I minus a. This is the value of e to the power a t, which is also equal to phi t, because it is called as state transition matrix and it is represented by phi t. So now some special properties of this state transition matrix are there, that at t equal to 0, phi 0 equal to e to the power a 0 equal to identity matrix. Another, phi t equal to e to the power a t If you are taking e to the power minus 80, inverse of e to the power minus 80, it is equal to 5 at t equal to minus t. Similarly, others, you can read from here. Now, considering an example where you have to calculate the determine the state transition matrix and its inverse for the system given here or defined by this expression x dot t equal to a x t. So here a equal to 0, 1, minus 2, minus 3. Initially, what you have to have? You have to calculate the value of s I minus a. So s into multiplied by the identity matrix minus a equal to this one. Simply, matrix of how you will be evaluating the inverse. Inverse of a matrix is followed by four steps calculation, that is calculating the matrix of minors, calculating the matrix of cofactors where you are getting the sign change, and calculating the adjugate, sometimes called as adjoint. How? Transpose of cofactor matrix and multiplication of this adjoint matrix to the determinant of the 1 over determinant of the matrix. That would be the inverse of a matrix. So initially you have to calculate the value of the minors. How these would be calculated? You know, matrix of cofactors, it is just the change of sign according to the coefficient of the element of the matrix. Like A11, it is positive, A12, it is negative, A13, it is positive, A21, it is negative, A22, it is positive, A23, it is negative, A31, it is positive, A32, it is negative, and A33, it is positive. So therefore, in cofactor matrix is easy because you have calculated the matrix of minors. So in adjugate, what you have to have? You have to simply change the row into column. So first row would be considered as first column. So s plus 3 minus 2 is s minus first column, and 1s is second column. So this is your inverse calculation of the s I minus a. So in this way you have calculated inverse, your adjugant, but multiplying by the determinant, you have also be to calculate the value of determinant s I minus a. So multiplying this, you can simply calculate the value of s I minus a, s into s plus 3 minus 2 into minus 1. So it is the expression. If you can also expand it by s square plus 2 s plus s plus 2, so it could be given by s plus 2 into s plus 1. So your state transition matrix would be left as inverse of si minus a inverse, but si minus a inverse is adjugate of si minus a over the determinant of this si minus a. So adjugate of si minus a, it is calculated here s plus 3 1 minus 2 s plus 3 1 minus 2 s, and the determinant is calculated here, that is s plus s square plus 3 s plus 2 or s plus 1 into s plus 2. So by putting these element in the elements of the matrix, so s plus 3 over s plus 1 into s plus 2, and next element will be 1 over s plus 1 into s plus 2, next it is minus 2 over s plus 1 into s plus 2, and similarly s over s plus 1 s plus 2. Now phi t is, that is the state transition matrix, equal to e to the power 80 is equal to Laplace inverse of si minus a inverse. So you have calculated the value of si a inverse. You have to simply take the Laplace inverse. So Laplace inverse of this factor
Now, how it would be possible actually to take the Laplace of these expressions? So from observation you can see that these fractions, these expressions can be converted to two expressions, some constant over s plus 1, some constant over s plus 2, and thereafter it is very much easy to determine the Laplace inverse. So we would ultimately doing this thing, right? So here see one expression, that is s plus 3 over s plus 1 into s plus 2, how it is converted to two factors, that is a over s plus 1 plus b over s plus 2 by using partial fraction method. So the value of a can be calculated by s plus 3 over s plus 1 into s plus 2 into s plus 1 at s equal to minus 1, and ultimately by solving it is equal to 2, and b equal to, since it should be multiplied by s plus 2 at s equal to minus 2, so remaining terms will be s plus 3 over s plus 1, and you are getting minus 1. Similarly for others as well, you can calculate the values of these constants, and ultimately you have to put these constants value in the matrix elements. So in this way you have determined the expressions by partial, using partial fraction. It is a11 element of the matrix, it is a12 element of the matrix, it is a21, it is a22, using partial fraction method in, as in previous slide. So now take the Laplace inverse of each of the element of the matrix. So it is very easy to determine Laplace inverse of 1 over s plus 1, it is always e power minus t, and Laplace inverse of 1 over s plus 2, it is e power minus 2t. So simply put the values of these Laplace inverse 2 into e power minus t minus e power minus 2t. In this expression it would be equal to e power minus t minus e power minus 2t, and for this it is minus 2 into e power minus t minus 2 into e power minus 2t. Here for this expression you are getting minus e power minus t plus 2 into e power minus 2t. So in this way you have determined the value of state transition matrix phi t just by using Laplace transform method. As far as second part of the question is concerned, that is inverse of state transition matrix, you can use the property of state transition matrix phi inverse of phi t equal to phi at t equal to minus t. So simply put t equal to minus t from in this expression to get inverse of this state transition matrix. So by putting this one you will be getting 2 into e power t minus e power minus ki jagah par instead of minus you would be getting e power 2t. So it is e power 2t. Similarly for this expression you are getting e power t minus e power 2t, e power t minus e power 2t, and for this expression. So you have completed the calculation of a state transition matrix, how it would be. So main aspect of this lecture is to include the two different methods of determining the state transition matrix, that is power series method and another is the Laplace method, and you find it is very much easy to compare that Laplace inverse method is, Laplace method is much much better than the power series method. As far as lower order systems is concerned, you can tackle both of the methods. But in case of higher order systems, it is too much difficult or very much tedious to deal with the power series method. Therefore, you should always use Laplace method for determining state transition matrix or solution of the systems. Thank you.